Welcome back, everybody, to what has been one hell of a series so far in the Trilogy Tour. It is the winner bracket final between Moscow 5 and Team Aspira. Currently, we are going into game number 3 after game number 1 was Moscow 5's game quite handedly. They took an early Roshan. They had a push lineup. It was all things that were looking really, really good for Moscow 5. Game number 2, though, much more even. Moscow 5 ended up throwing away game number 1, lost it to Aspira's better late game, and ended up giving that one away. Game number 2, much more even. Team Aspira almost coming back off of a better late game advantage for Moscow 5, but one critical decision by them to try and push down the second set of racks as the Tidehunter was coming back up ends up costing them the game entirely. And we are now jumping into game number 3. As we already have the draft underway, and it's going to be quite the interesting one here because we can see Moscow 5 really loving what they already have set up here. A Lycan and Vengeful Spirit.
10 seconds.
Physical damage, minus armor, pushing power. These two have it all.
5 seconds.
Team Aspira, meanwhile, they pick up the ever-popular Slark in this series, as that is actually...
Reserve time.
Yeah, the Slark has won all of his games. The Slark won for Team Aspira in game number 1. And then, who had Slark last game? Nobody had Slark last game, did they? A Faceless Void. No. We had Slark on the side of Moscow 5 because they had a Slark as well as a Naga Siren. So far, Slark is 100% in this series. It's getting a little late. I'm getting a little tired. Sorry. Slark and Ogre Magi is going to be the 1-2 pickup, though, by Team Aspira. So they definitely get one of the highest profile supports in the game, that's for sure, while at the same time getting a carry that seems to be favored by both sides. Though I would much rather have the Lycan than I would the Slark, but that's just me personally. I feel like the Slark is going to be really exposed to specifically what Lycan brings to the table, which is a lot of pushing power and a lot of potential 5-manning. So Slark is going to have to be ready for that one, that's for sure. Couple of bans coming out. We did have the Omni Knight as well as the Tidehunter banned away by Moscow 5. That seems to be a consistent ban by them. Meanwhile, the Visage is going to be taken out by Team Aspira. Don't want to be letting the Visage Lycan or potentially even the Visage Drow Ranger Lycan combination go through to Moscow 5. They already have a lot of physical damage. No sense in letting them have anything extra, that's for sure. So they take away the Visage and as well as the Puck. As Puck is definitely one of the best initiators for a Lycan. The Dream Coil is actually a really good setup holding ability for the Lycan to come in with his Wolf to tear things up. But it's also one of the best counters versus Storm Spirit. As Storm Spirit doesn't really want to get an early BKB, so that silence can be devastating for a Storm Spirit. So Team Aspira, really nice 1-2 combo there, banning away the Puck and picking up the Storm Spirit. Now the Tuskar is going to be picked up by Team Moscow 5, which is certainly interesting. I think that Tusk is a really underrated support hero right now, and certainly works very, very well with the Vengeful Spirit as he outputs a large amount of physical damage, especially thanks to his ultimate. So the minus armor and increase of damage thanks to the Command Aura can do a lot extra for the Tusk. Witch Doctor, though, is going to be picked up by Team Aspira. And, whoa, Pugna, all in push from Moscow 5. Looks like they don't want to let this game go too late at all. With the Lycan and Pugna on one side, this should spell the doom of all of the Outer Towers and potentially the Raxes by about 25 to 35 minutes in.
Dire's ban.
Ban away by Team Aspira. They want to make sure that they can take away some of the best laners up against the Storm Spirit, as well as any of the really good... it's actually interesting they ban away the Viper, because presumably the Pugna would be...
10 seconds to go.
...mid here. Either that or the Lycan, so...
5 seconds.
I guess they are fearing some sort of aggro try coming out from Moscow 5. I really don't think that's the case.
Reserve time.
That's a couple of times where Team Aspira's last ban has been kind of questionable for me, and it seems like they're always kind of scared of aggro tries. But either way, they want to ban away the Viper, a very mid-game oriented hero that is able to pick a quick mech, have a lot of stats, definitely fits into a pushing lineup quite well, while the Centaur is going to be banned away by Moscow 5, one of the best offlaners left in the pool. Team of Spear, though, do they go for... I mean, Clockwork is not that bad here. Normally, I don't like Clockwork, but in this game, I think Clockwork creates a lot of space for the Storm Spirit. Could potentially set up easy death wards for the Witch Doctor, as well as a really good holder versus the Lycan. If you're able to get a Force Staff on your Clockwork, just getting cogs on inside, get the Lycan inside of the cogs, and then Force Staffing yourself out is a really good way of being able to hold him for a good amount of time. If you don't have that Force Staff, just cogging the Lycan back through a more defensive use of the ability works fairly well. And then, of course, the Clockwork would be really good lockdown up against the Pugnum. Axe. It would be his continual shot. But instead, they Dyer's go for a different initiator. They're going to pick the Red Man himself. The Axe is going to be the fifth pickup for Team Aspira. Quite interesting. They know there's going to be probably a lot of minions out in the pool, right? You have the creeps moving forward, but then you have all of Lycan Wolves, as well as potentially Necrobooks coming out from both him, as well as the Pugna, maybe. So if he can get a really good call, he can do a lot of work thanks to the all the spins that he does, thanks to the extra right clicks coming out. So still prefer Moscow 5's lineup.
Reserve time. 10 seconds.
Not quite so sure about the Axe pickup, but no matter what they grabbed as their last pick, I think I would prefer Moscow 5's lineup quite heavily. And their last pick is going to be the Venomancer here. So are they going to be running some sort of aggro try with the... do they run an aggro Pugna try lane? This is kind of weird. Because Venomancer, so Slander is the offlane picker, offlane player for Moscow 5, and he's going to be playing the Venomancer here. Do Team Aspira run an aggro try? I don't think so. I am quite puzzled by this draft. I think all things around, like, Tusk and Vengeful Spirit are really good in aggro try, but there's no third hero that is actually good in aggro tri lanes. Pugna would be your best hero solely because he does a huge amount of damage, but he's also really, really squishy, so it doesn't actually mean he's ideal. Venomancer needs levels, and he's better in 1v1 scenarios, and the Lycan, definitely not an aggro tri hero, that's for sure. So, we're going to start out with a pause. We'll see what happens. Necroman... What I think is going to be happening here is an aggro try with Tusk, Vengeful Spirit, Pugna, Venomancer as our mid up against the Storm Spirit and Lycan safe lane, or they run a defensive try lane and just put Venomancer as some sort of offlane solo. One way or the other, either way, I'm just confused by their laning phase, and I feel like I'm just kind of taking stabs at the dark when I make these calls for Moscow 5 in this game specifically. This is quite odd. Aspira are going to be running a 5-man into their own jungle, perhaps anticipating the 5-man here of Moscow 5. They do have the snowball, and this makes it quite dangerous. They could quite easily get the first blood. They're going to start out with a ward behind the tower. And oh dear. They're going to be going on the Ogre Magi to start. Snowball, snowball, snowball. King R is running the wrong direction here. He needs to be with the rest of his allies, and he will be giving away the first blood. Quickly surrounded. If you get hit by the snowball in that situation, well, I guess maybe he felt like his team wouldn't be very good at a level 1 fight, but I don't know. Going on the Ogre Magi is probably the best thing for them. Oh, more snowball. Android trying to get in range of the tower as soon as possible, but round 2 with the Pugna Blast. 2 early kills before the horn blows for the side of Moscow 5. And perhaps a little bit of a bad-mannered good luck, have fun from Necroman to start this match out. They are going to be running the aggro Pugna tri-lane with the Venomancer. No, not the Venomancer in the mid lane. Bit surprised, Venomancer would certainly fare much better up against the Storm Spirit, but they're going to put the Veno instead, and the top lane, where he's going to be facing Slark and Witch Doctor. They're only going to be doing a defensive dual lane here in the bottom, as they know it is going to be an aggro try coming out from Team Moscow 5. So they're going to try and upset things a little bit by putting the Axe there with a protective hero. And the Slark plus one should actually be pretty good versus the Venomancer. If they manage to ever get a stun, if they manage to ever get a good cask and followed up with the pounce, they can potentially kill Slander. Look at this early rotation. The power of the Tusk. He gets the snowball, and Sharfeek is going to be falling, joining the rest of his allies, it seems like. 1-3 on the board. The Vengeful Spirit suicided for Roshan. I was like, where did that one come from? What in the world? Did I miss a kill? But no. Somebody suicided to neutrals. In fact, the Vengeful Spirit suicided to the Roshan. So this is how they're going to be running it. Not really an aggro try, just a aggro roaming dual lane. They're going to be able to catch out PGG here. Bit of a mistake by him to try and cut through the river like that. Gets caught, and Screen wasn't there to save him with a snowball either, so. This time, Aspira, ignore what's on the board. Now they are one kill up. Our matchup in the bottom lane means Axe versus... Oh, he actually managed to catch the Pugna here. It's going to do a decent amount of damage. Maybe not quite as many spins as he was hoping for, though. Our mid matchup is actually quite favorable for the Storm Spirit. Storm Spirit versus any melees is going to be pretty nice. As you can see, Storm Spirit is actually way ahead of Necroman, despite the fact that he did get ganked up fairly early on. So that's why I kind of assumed Venomancer was going to be our mid here, but apparently not. Oh, Apathy actually gets hit by that clap. Unfortunate situation. He will get one of the last hits. Pounce away. They're going to turn on Android, though. And he's completely caught out. Very bad position to be sitting in against a Tusk. His Icicle Shards obviously are perfect for closing out that exit. Oh, they're still going to go for Apathy here. In fact, he does have a pounce. If he can just get away from these heroes, he will get far enough away. Won't be falling there. But still, the constant aggression of this Tusk Vengeful Spirit is definitely ripping Aspira a new one, that's for sure.
Denied.
Bottom lane, some rotations of their own. Pugna's going to be caught out here. Ignite's going to slow him down. Axe doesn't actually go for the one level of Battle Hunker. Ogre Magi will be able to stun him up. The follow-up call, they're going to need some spins here to ensure the kill. And it looks like they'll get it too, especially with the body blocking. Storm Spirit, right-click somebody. Axe. All right, he gets him.
Axe, use your
for a second there, I thought he wasn't going to right-click him. That was a bit odd. Look at them. They just do not stop. Screen and PGG. Rotating around now behind the tower. The snowball. Nope. Not going to be in range. And I don't think they want to be diving that deep anyway. Not up against a Witch Doctor. Good call by Screen to hold off on that one, because obviously Witch Doctor, probably one of the worst heroes you can snowball into, because if you don't chain stun him down, he's going to cask you and he's going to stun you for a very long time with only two units close together like that. Oh, Pugna's going to be caught out again here as the Slark makes the rotation to the bottom lane. The blast goes out and it's going to do a huge amount of damage, but it's still going to be enough for a kill. They not only get that, but the ward on top of that, which means an extra 20 gold go in the way of Apathy. So the rotations are real. Everyone just moving around the map as much as possible. And it is causing quite the upsets here. Oh, maybe Lycan is, well, now that he hits level 5, the wolves are going to be causing some issues for the Storm Sphere. Block out the Icicle Shards. Not quite perfect placement there. And Sharfeek will be fine. Meanwhile, at the top lane, looks like a cask. Managed to catch out PGG here. The slow, not going to catch the Axe, though he will miss the call. And unfortunately, that means that PGG will get himself out.
Could use a hand.
So I guess there is this little bit of a gap. At level 5 specifically, the wolves are really strong. And uh-oh, Sharfeek's going to be going down here. Chased down by the wolf. Doesn't look like the teleport's going to come in time. Oh, he actually makes the grab. Maybe a stun goes out. Necromant's in some serious trouble. The wolves are going to try and clean up the storm spirit, but it's not going to be good enough. And Lycan does get taken out by the axe. Rotations, rotations, rotations. That is the name of the game right now. Speaking of which, bottom lane, Apathy, ooh, just one step ahead of that Icicle Shards. But it's all about the rotations and who makes better, more efficient use of them. Tier 1 tower did already go down in the top lane, though the fact that Aspira are actually tied up in kills, again, ignore one of those kills. It's currently 4-4 in the favor. Well, in the favor of nobody right now, but it's going to be in the favor of Aspira as they find the Pugna. 6-4, 5-4, rather. And Aspira, now that the Storm Spirit is level 6, the fact that the laning phase was going all right for them, and they're actually getting a decent number of counter kills without the Storm Spirit being level 6, now that he's got that big jump, everything is so much easier. Now, Screen did see that Invis rune being picked up thanks to this ward right here, so he should not be moving far enough forward to get caught by Sharfeek. So it looks like they should be okay. Top lane, though, that's where the cask is going to be going down. Axe trying to catch up, but, oh, look at that. Mass TP's out, and they immediately back themselves away. Both of them are going to survive. Nicely played. Good reactions there from Aspira. Seriously, they turned on a dime there, both of them, at the exact same time as the double TP's went up. So quite well played. No max repost in my chat. Thank you very much. Jump in. PGG's going to be grabbed out. Sharfeek will be able to get the kill there. And has enough space to get himself away as well. Oh, the Lycan's actually going to try and go for this one. Sharfeek's actually all out of bottle charges here. We do have a call coming up. Axe gets a big one. Sharfeek tried to teleport out. Oh my god, he's successful. What a huge play there from Aspira. The Axe is going to be chased down here, but he may have enough armor. Nice blocking with the wolves. Oh, actually, maybe not. Not so nice. And the Lycan ultimate does wear out. Meanwhile, PGG is going to be falling here to Apathy. Ooh, oh, well, maybe a snowball. He does have a pounce up in 3 seconds. They're going to need to surround the Slark, but he's already away. They lost vision of him, so he's too fast. Top lane Slander's going to be caught out here. Storm Spirit gets another one. Sharfeek, 2-1-2 on his Storm Spirit. He's looking pretty hot right now. He may not have the most levels in the world, but he's providing a huge impact moving around the map like he is. Seriously, I can't get over what a good play that was. The Axe coming over, meeting the Storm Spirit for a call, and the teleport getting the Storm Spirit out like that was just beautiful. Storm Spirit now going to try and make a jump onto the Lycan while he doesn't have his ultimate. Mass TP's come out, but it looks like they're still going to try and commit for the kill on the Lycan, and they'll get it too. Axe comes in. No, the snowball. It'll save him for a second. He still gets the dunk on one. Screen gets low, unable to get a dunk on him, but the multicast comes out. There goes the Tusk. Sharfeek's going to fall in exchange. 2-for-2 exchange so far. And that's going to be in the favor of Moscow 5. They killed two cores in exchange for a core and a support. But mass teleports, actually. It's actually fairly even. The trade-off itself favorable to Moscow 5, but Slark didn't need to rotate. Trying to bust down radio structure. And he's just free-farming the bottom lane, so. Maybe I miscalled that. Maybe it's actually the favor of Aspira. Tier 1 tower is going to be going down here, but not without a fight. Multicast onto Slander. If they can get a cask, well, he gets off the ultimate. And the Axe is going to be in some serious trouble, but not very much as the Slark comes in. Jump in, Storm Spirit, not quite enough time to get the grab onto the Pugna, who makes a nice teleport away at just the right time. The Axe, meanwhile, did survive through his Poison Nova encounter. And, well, a support for a core. Aspira, they may have lost the tower, but it's to be expected against this heavy push lineup. But what may not be expected, or at least from Aspira's point of view, the Roshan. Roshan currently being done by Moscow 5. They do have the Vladimirs up on the Lycan, meaning it is quite easy for them to take Rosh. But you throw in some minus armor and it gets even easier. Ace Rune, and an Aegis.
What? Thanks to the Dire.
I'm just freaking out here because Blue says my mistake. I think this is a best of three. I'm not sure why he's. Oh, maybe he told the team the wrong thing at one point. Because this should be a best of three. To my knowledge, it is a best of three. Oh, okay. He accidentally put best of five in the game format. Yeah, okay. I get it. That's why he sent his back. Let's see whether or not a spear actually turn and fight this one now. The tier one tower's already out. Seriously, the pushing power of Moscow 5 is so insane.
Radiant's bottom tower ain't a pretty sight right now.
No sense in fighting it, or at least not right now. Not while they have Aegis. Maybe as they push out, if they can get some sort of sneaky grab here. They've already been spotted out by the ward, though. So there is no essence of surprise for Aspira. Moscow 5, move forward, PGG, swap in. Whoa, causing some chaos there with that one. Misses the magic missile. Screen gets off the snowball. Aspira, meanwhile, well, you're going to see your axe trying to do as much spin damage. He's still going to be taken out, though. Aspira is running low here. Apathy trying to get himself out. Oh, what a good death ward. They actually managed to kill the Pugna in the process. Apathy trying to kill the ward for the Storm Spirit is going to help him out quite heavily. Screen is low, and maybe they can get that one kill, but it's going to be a tough one. Apathy goes in for it. Storm Spirit makes a long jump, unable to get it, and oh, nice snowball. It's going to be able to clean up Sharfeek as well. Apathy on his way out, going to be chased, but actually not chased out by Necroman, who had the Haste Rune. Thanks to the Icicle Shards block out, Moscow 5 will just have to content themselves for a tier 2. They won a great fight. I'm not sure what PGG's move was there, but it was an odd one, that's for sure. The running over like that and swapping when he just could have stunned the Storm Spirit right there was really weird. Regen rune gonna be picked up.
Regeneration.
Oh, actually, he couldn't have stunned the Storm Spirit because he didn't see him. Maybe he didn't realize the Storm Spirit was there. I mean, they should have seen the Storm Spirit going into that hole. But they wouldn't actually see the Storm Spirit inside of it, of course, so. Maybe they lost track of who was where. Net worth rise. No surprise that the Lycan is far, far ahead of anybody else. Especially with all the towers going down, but he's also picking up most of the kills. Moscow 5 are maybe trying to set up for a kill on Sharfeek. Not with these here, so they need some extra rotations. They need maybe the Tusk. I don't know. All around, this Storm Spirit should have a fairly good time. There aren't really a whole lot of disables that are threatening to him. Magic Missile is a missile, hence the name. But it's a missile, so you wouldn't really expect. Oh, they're actually going to jump forward here, but the Lycan is going to be coming in from behind. They're going to try and go on Slander, and they will get him too. Before he gets off his ultimate, but now they run back and all of a sudden they realize, oh god, we were surrounded. There goes the Slark. King R managed to teleport himself away. Nicely played. Axe also blinking out. So that wasn't too bad there. Moscow 5 kind of blew a lot in order to get just that one kill on the Slark, and even that was quite close. They will get a tier 2 though. And Moscow 5, well, Storm Spirit jumps in. Oh, what a beautiful call! The Tusk Guard, though, with the big save snowball, saves everyone's life. And now they'll turn onto the Axe, who's in some serious trouble. Cass goes out, take away the Aegis. There goes the Tusk Guard as well. PGG in the background, he's going to be chased down by Sharfeek as well. Necroman comes back. Where's the stun? It's not there. Sharfeek unable to get there in time to stop him. He didn't have it up anyway, but still. What a beautiful call there from the Axe, the Tusk, with an equally good snowball counterplay. That was almost complete disaster for the side of Moscow 5. Still wasn't a great fight for them. But it could have been so, so much worse with a three-man call like that. These two teams, man, have been providing one hell of an exciting matchup so far. This series has had everything, I think. The throws, the close games, the game 3. Apathy, he's going to be able to pick up his Blink Dagger here very soon. Did we actually have any Hand of Midas? No Hand of Midas is on the side of Moscow 5, and you wouldn't expect them to go for it. Oh, Screen may be caught out here. He's going to throw out the Snowball, but he didn't expect Apathy to be here. Snowball runs its course. Slark waiting patiently to be able to hit the pounce. Will be able to get it too. Screen goes down, but here comes the rest of the team. Call in on two. Nice play. And they're going to be able to grab him too. Slender, if they can lock him down before he gets off the Poison Nova. No, he gets it off. They're all out of mana on Sharfeek as well. He's going to fall. Apathy just here for the cleanup as much as possible. The rest of the team, though, in some serious trouble. Nice teleport away from King R. Damn, that guy's been impressing me. King R has pulled out some serious sick support play. Game number two, his Skywrath Mage was insane. This game, he's had very clutch TPs, two in a row at the right times. Managed to TP himself out, though, as Spira did lose that fight. It was only because of the fact that Slark was able to pick up a couple of kills there that it made it okay for Spira. Sharfeek, he had a really excellent game number two. But his Storm Spirit play has been a little bit off so far. It seems like it kind of going that way, right? Game one, Apathy performed so well on the Slark. And Sharfeek, I say, wasn't as much of a factor. And then game number two, Sharfeek was like carrying everything he could despite some of Apathy's misplays. And then maybe it's going the opposite way here for game number three. Sharfeek has had, I think, some jumps where he has just gone way too far. Now he's going to be knocked up. He needs to try and get out. Oh my god, he dies before he can actually get himself away. He tried to bank on the Invis rune rather than just running out. And the axe. Well, he'll blink himself away before anybody gets there. Necroman trying to get close, but is not close enough.
Dire's bottom tower's getting the business.
Bottom lane, Apathy is trying to go for the tier 1. Got to trade away this tier 2 in the middle lane. But I think that kind of shows it right there, that Storm Spirit jumped onto the rune and trying to bank on the Invis rune to save him more than anything else ends up costing him a free pickoff. PGG almost getting the swap there on King R.
Radiant's mid tower's getting banked.
Not quite.
Radiant's mid tower's in trouble.
Moscow 5. Going in for the game ending push, possibly. Think they should really wait on Roshan number 2. I don't think they're quite yet ready to push. Sharfeek. Trying to clean up the Necronomicon minions. We'll be able to get some of that gold. Well, he got the melee one. Really wants to be able to have his Orchid. But this is the problem. Espira, the same problem that Slark has in that he's not very good in 5-on-5 teamfights most of the time is the same problem Storm Spirit has. So when Moscow 5 are continually staying 5-manned, Espira don't really have a whole lot of openings at all. -17, 18.5 minutes in, a quite even experience graph, but the gold should be much more in the favor of Moscow 5. Over a 4,000 lead for them. We do have the pickoff crew running around. Sharfeek at level 11 is looking for a kill in the enemy jungle with King R, who is also level 11. Has a big time multicast. Let's see if they can get Slender here in the middle lane. Set it up. Trying to grab him. Oh, too far. TP scrolls, and Sharfeek forces that and backs himself away. That was actually three different TPs blown. 300 gold for basically 300 mana. Not too bad. Tier 1 tower does go down to the bottom lane. Apathy actually missing the deny there as the illusions were able to clean it up. That's awkward. Uh-oh. They better get out, and they better get out soon. Screen is on his way. He's going to block away the exit. He's going to go for Android. Blink away by the Slark. They're just going to get that one kill. The Slark already getting himself far enough out. In fact, he's going to stop the incoming creep wave. Best thing he can do, actually. This is really smart of him.
Mid-tower's having technical difficulties.
Yeah, this is actually really well done. Same thing is happening in the middle lane. The Storm Spirit's cutting behind the Tier 1 tower. PGG trying to chase him away as best as he can. Apathy will TP out. this long, long Roshan is really playing against Moscow 5 right now, because they really should be able to take it without any interference from Espear, or at least they could have. But the time is drawn out, and maybe the next 30 seconds, Espear have enough strength, especially with an Invis rune on the Storm Spirit. Free pickoff potentially on PGG. Yep, they're going to get it too. Trying to dodge the magic missile, holds him in just long enough, trying to dodge. Oh no, he gets caught in! PGG lives! Oh, the big mech play plus screen, putting a stop to the Storm Spirit's aggression. So close to being able to get that kill and get out, but the Storm Spirit unfortunately misses that opportunity. And look at them, they're still waiting for Roshan. They're actually going to give away a tier 1 tower in the top lane potentially. If, TP in from Lycan. And now Roshan shows up, but without their Lycan. And maybe, just maybe, they can get a kill on him. Lycan actually pops his ultimate just to run all the way down to Roshan here. And Espira, we're actually setting up a potential kill on the Lycan, which would have been so huge. But it's not going to happen. Instead, Roshan's going to be cleaned up. I guess that's one way to use the ultimate. Run from top to bottom. He'll grab the Aegis for himself. Tier 1 tower is still going to fall, though. Again, that late Roshan really playing against them. A whole entire tower being picked up by Espira because of that. Slark still needs a lot of room. I wonder if he goes for a BKB over the Scotty in this game. I want to point out real quickly, it is not a best of 5, it is a best of 3. I see a couple of people in the chat mentioning something like that. It is a best of 3. It was a mistake to have the best of 5 formatting, the admin just made a small error. The dire not a big deal. Die in their top tower. Anyway, well, let's see. If Apathy is able to farm up another 1,000 gold, it means BKB. I'm not sure if Scotty is. I just don't think he's going to have time to farm up Scotty. That's my biggest deal. And BKB is definitely going to be very effective versus the Pugna. Tuskar, Venomancer, as well as Eventual Spirit. Even if it isn't very good versus the Lycan, it's good against all those other heroes. Lycan does build for a heart here. It's definitely a large lack of damage here on the side of Espira. And if Lycan can be the frontliner in pushing down these towers and allow the Pugna to have a lot more room. Here comes the Necronomicon push plus... Well, there goes their tower. The Nether Blast already doing a lot. Jump in, grab on two. And now the Snowball to be able to save them as well. There goes the Axe. Immediate buyback. Apathy, meanwhile, getting stunned up, is going to be able to go for the ward. They're going in very, very deep. They actually still have the Snowball. They actually followed all the way to the Axe. What a huge play from TWX with the buyback there. That was huge. Android P is still Espira getting wrecked inside of their own tier fours. But it's the best fight they could hope for at this point in time. Apathy trying to track down whatever kills he can. They're actually going to be enough here. Apathy, can he get him with the pounce? Oh, not quite enough for the kill. Jump in, long range jump is going to be able to grab PGG. Slows him down. And just trying to set it up for TWX to get close enough. Yep, there goes the slow. PGG will be killed by Espira. So at least they get something. They actually keep their racks alive. That was huge. I was wondering, like, why the hell did the Snowball just zip away there? It was because the Snowball, I believe. I didn't see it correctly, but I believe the Snowball was on the Axe, and when he bought back the Snowball, when it released, still went for the Axe. So it chased them all the way into the Tier 4 towers, resulting in a fight that Espira could actually do okay in. Unfortunately, what they can't do okay in is that middle tier 1 tower push where the Axe gets caught, taken down by a nice little combination between the Tusk and the Pugna. Apathy, desperate to try and buy time here. He is going to be going for the Scotty in this game, but he's trying to cut creeps as best as he can. Does manage to get at least that one rune. But he knows the next push is going to be Rax, and Espira are not ready for it at all. He's going to go for the bottom tier 1 tower. The best thing for him, I guess, at this point. Like, he will be able to have... Oh, he actually already used his buyback last time. So, this could be the game ender right here. Moscow 5 on the verge of going to the grand finals of the Trilogy Tour. just need to finish off this last push. They're going to be able to take that melee Rax, making the transition to the bottom lane. Stormsphere jumps forward, trying to grab the Nether Ward, I guess. Stun onto Necroman, though he does have the Aegis. So he is more than happy to accept some damage at this point, especially with the heart coming in for him as well. Moscow 5 don't really have a good initiating force, but it doesn't matter. They're forcing Aspira to initiate on them because they have the better pushing power. Android P actually gets swapped and taken out real quickly. Sharp Feet goes for the Pugna in the background, but he needs to get out of here. Makes a zip back to the fountain. Meanwhile, Aspira actually trying to dunk Slander, doesn't quite get it. Apathy's going for the kill, but he may not get it in as well. And Slander just barely lives. Jump in by the Storms here, gets it, but the burnout from the Nether Ward is going to cost him his life. They take the second set of racks. They kill the Storm Spirit. Storm Spirit with a buyback with two racks down 26 minutes into this game. Sharfeek, he's got to pull so many moves here to be able to even out this game. Sharfeek gets hit by the stun, combo down, and I'm thinking that's going to be the game with a full minute left on the clock here. They can quite easily take that third set of racks, I think. Android P comes back. Trying to fight up against PGG. King R trying to get close enough for screen. Isn't going to be able to get that stun. PGG, meanwhile, chase down Maledict. Oh, swap goes down. And now the snowball to chase out Android. He's going to be able to get that one kill. Meanwhile, somewhere in the top area, we do have the melee creeps. The melee axe and range racks going down. And well played from Moscow 5. I went into this series thinking that Moscow 5 was the better team. And I had a crisis of faith there. I really did. Game number one, Moscow 5, strategy. I think strategy is really what won Moscow 5. Could have won them all three of these games. Game one, they could have won through strategy entirely. They actually had some really big misplays as Aspira just straight up outplayed them. And it was like, Aspira, if they manage to draft better, they don't have the surprise Roshan, they just maybe draft a little bit better, and they play the same level, game two easily theirs. Moscow 5 barely etch out a win in game number two. Really, really close series that went to like over an hour long. Moscow 5 barely managed to take that game, and then game number three won, I would say, primarily through their draft and their strategy. I mean, running this heavy push lineup up against Aspira, who had like a Slark and a Storm Spirit. Like, they were really lacking heroes that could do much in a team fight. Both Storm Spirit and Slark are notorious for being bad against five-man push lineups like this. So the fact that Aspira went ahead and grabbed them both left them really exposed. So Aspira, like, they played really well, but they're going to have to do a little bit more research, I think, when it comes to drafts. I think that's one of their biggest downsides is drafting, is that Moscow 5 is quite good at it. And Aspira, not quite so much. Still, though, really looking forward to see them. For me, it's between Aspira and Hellraisers as the two teams that could make it into the Grand Finals. Power Rangers and Deuce are good teams, but from what I've seen, both Aspira and Hellraisers by far the better teams. So really looking forward to seeing the rest of Aspira in the Trilogy Tour. And, of course, Moscow 5, congratulations to them, already making it into the Grand Finals. So that is going to be it for the night, guys. It has been quite the long series. And I was just about to check over if Toby's Izo Cup was finished up. It looks like he finished up just a few minutes ago. So Join Dota is completely done for the night. Both Join Dota Red and Join Dota Blue are going to be closing out for the night. So thank you so much for tuning in. I had a blast casting this series.